Look, Cog, look! Did you know that carbon dioxide, or CO2 for short, comes out of our lungs? Yes, we're exhaling CO2 all the time. Plants need it. We need the oxygen they emit. To understand it, we'll need to look into cellular respiration, which is a lot more interesting than it sounds. You are made of cells like skin cells, muscle cells, intestine cells, and so on. Those cells need energy, which they get from cellular respiration. It's kind of interesting how that's linked to the CO2 you exhale. Here's a way to understand cellular respiration. Imagine this, Cog. A new ride opens at the amusement park. You can enter with inhaled oxygen and exit with exhaled CO2. That sounds like a blast. Who could resist? So you step right up, grab that oxygen molecule to ride. You're pulled into the lungs. You slip through the lung membranes to get into the arteries. Quick, grab a ride on a red blood cell in the blood plasma river. You're gonna travel through the heart, ba-boom, ba-boom, and out to the cells. Looks like you're heading to the brain this time. This is where you leap off your red blood cell and wiggle into a brain cell. Jump! Phew, you made it. More oxygens join you, and there's this weird glucose molecule too. They're all heading into the cellular respiration pathway, so you get in line. But wait, the ride stops. You gotta sign the waiver first. It says that only one glucose and six O2s can enter. Better read the small print. Warning, molecules that enter will look very different coming out. We are not responsible for your safety.
Will you sign it, Cog? Yay, you signed it.
Look, the atoms form new molecules, carbon dioxides, waters, and the cell gets chemical energy. Uh-oh, Cog. Get yourself together and get out of there. If you grab a water molecule to exit, you might end up water vapor in breath. Or maybe you'd end up in sweat, or tears, or pee, or poop. Ew, seems risky. Better grab a CO2. Jump into the plasma river, back through the heart, into the lungs, and it's over. You're exhausted, Cog. Go get some cotton candy. Maybe your brain cells are using energy right now to think, hey, what's up with that glucose? Where did that come from? Well, glucose looks like this. We simplify it and draw it as a hexagon. Looking at the big picture, one glucose and six O2s went in. That's a total of six carbons, 12 hydrogens, and 18 oxygens. The same atoms came out as six carbon dioxides and six waters. Glucose really puts the carbons in the carbon dioxide we exhale. So where did the glucose come from? Well, that's an interesting story. Glucose and other carbohydrates, or carbs, are in your food, even if you've never ordered the glucose blue plate special at a diner. Some carbs are simple and fast-acting. Then there are complex carbs that give more long-lasting energy. Let's look at some simple carbs. Glucose is in veggies. Fructose is in fruit. Galactose is in milk. Look, they all have six carbons, 12 hydrogens, and six oxygens. But their structures aren't identical. The sugar in Cog's cotton candy is sucrose, a glucose and fructose molecule joined together. Simple carbs may have to make some tweaks, but they're all going to end up in the cellular respiration pathway, even if they have to go through the side doors. Now I'll add some complex carbs like beans, rice, peas, sweet potatoes, and bread. The carbs in these foods are long chains of simple carbs. They're going to break down and enter the cellular respiration pathway by side doors too. They'll also turn into CO2 and water and energy. But what about fats? Now, this is really interesting. Has anyone ever told you they lost a pound or a half a kilogram of fat? Where did it go? Did they leave it at a restaurant? Did it fall between the couch cushions? Did it wander off from the park? No! That fat met up with oxygen and, wait, before you guess what happens, you need to know that fats are also made of carbons, oxygens, and hydrogens. Something like this. Ready to guess now? Yes! Fats break down into pieces that can enter the cellular respiration pathway by side doors. We know what's going to happen in there. We don't really lose fat. We just turn it into CO2, water, and chemical energy for our cells. Fats also put the carbon in carbon dioxide. You exhale about 100 times more CO2 than you inhale. It's enough to see in this experiment. First, you need to know that CO2 and water can form a weak acid, carbonic acid. Second, you need to know that it's easy to make an acid indicator that turns red in the presence of acid. Put 3 big red cabbage leaves in 3 cups of boiled water. Let it cool. Take out the leaves. Acidic lemon juice turns the indicator red. Now, exhale into the water an indicator. The CO2 in your breath forms some carbonic acid that caused a color change. Check it out on the pH scale. Water is neutral, about 7 on the pH scale. Lemon juice, a strong acid, at about 2 on the pH scale. Our carbonic acid is about 5.7. But don't panic. CO2 from cells is not causing climate change. In Earth's beautifully balanced system, animals take in oxygen and give off CO2. So do plants. Of course they do. They need chemical energy to stay alive, too. And lots of decomposers like fungi, bacteria, and protists take in oxygen to turn things like moose poop into CO2, water, and chemical energy. Even mosquito larvae breathing through their butt snorkels. Yes, that's a thing. Take in oxygen and give off CO2. It's all good. Plants will use that CO2 to photosynthesize. Let's recap. You are made of cells that use oxygen and food to get energy via the cellular respiration pathway. Glucose can enter the pathway through the front door, but other foods can enter through side doors. What comes out is carbon dioxide, water, and chemical energy. We exhale about 100 times more CO2 than we inhale, but the CO2 from cells does not cause climate change. Of course, cellular respiration isn't the whole story. Some cells, like yeast for example, can break down food to get usable energy without any oxygen. They get less energy and they make less CO2 from a glucose molecule. But it works for them, and we like it because that CO2 makes our bread fluffy. Wait! Don't fall asleep. We've barely scratched the surface of where CO2 comes from. For example, did you know CO2 comes out of our...